How's it going, guys? It's Joshua again from MultiVow with the PSAT section number 3. Question number 4 says the following. Triangle ABC above is isosceles with AB equal to AC. So this length here is equal to AC. And BC equals 48. The ratio of DE to DF is 5:7. What is the length of DC? Okay. First of all, let me say that for the new SAT, they really want you to have a very solid background on geometry. So my suggestion is go back to geometry, read all the postulates, read all the triangle theorems, and really get into that because you're going to need it. So let's start with the first sentence. It says is isosceles. What does that mean in terms of this triangle? Well, if a triangle is isosceles, then the opposite angles of the sides that are congruent are also congruent. So AB, the angle that's opposite to this is C, or D or BCA, that angle is congruent to the opposite side of AC. Okay? We don't know the value of those, but because these two are congruent, then it must be that these also are congruent. Right? Because these triangles are symmetric, because if they have a ratio, it's because they're similar, and similar triangles means that they have the same angles, right? So this angle is congruent to this one. This one is 90 degrees, which is also congruent. Therefore, these two are also congruent. So that's good to know as far as the exercise. Now, let's go ahead and get to the other information. BC equals 48. So what does that give me? Well, if D is in the line BC, that means that BD plus DC is BC. But we know that BC is 48, therefore BD plus DC is equal to 48. Okay? Now, what else do I know? Well, now we use the information of the ratio. And again, because these two triangles are similar, not necessarily congruent, but they are similar, we can create a ratio. So which ratio do you think I should choose? Well, they already gave me DE to DF, DE to DF. I'm going to choose BD and DC, right? Because they're similar, so I can use that ratio. So BD to DE is equal to DC to DF, okay? By similar triangles. Now, how do I use this information? Well, we know DE to DF is 5/7, so DE to DF is 5/7. Therefore, I can multiply DE in both sides, so that means that BD equals DC times DE over DF. Okay, now that is equal to DC times the fraction DE over DF, right? Because DC, I can write it over 1. So, therefore these are two are equal. But what is d over df? It's 5/7. So let's plug in that information. So we have that bd is equal to dc times 5/7. But where can I substitute this? Well, in our original equation that we formed, that BD plus DC equals 48. So let's substitute BD for DC times 5/7 into this equation. So that gives me the following, that 5/7 DC plus DC equals 48. Okay, so now what is 5/7 plus DC? Notice that there's a 1 here. So 5/7 plus 1 is just equivalent to 5/7 plus 7/7. So 5 plus 7 is 12. So we have that 12/7 DC equals 48. Therefore, we multiply by the reciprocal on both sides and we get that DC is equal to 48 times 7/12. If you do the calculation, you'll find that DC equals 28. So where is the answer? The answer is D, 28. Well, thanks again, guys, for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please like the video, subscribe to Motival, and share it with your closest friends. Thank you. Have a great day.